Yes, guys. Under corporate restructuring, the next chapter that we are supposed to see is demerger. Well, we'll have two types of demergers to talk about. The first type of demerger is a simple demerger. Well, let's say I have a company A Limited. This company A Limited has two divisions, X division and Y division. There are not two more companies, they are divisions. A Limited has an X division and also a Y division. Let's say this Y division particularly, they wanted to concentrate on this Y division. So they thought they do not want to keep both the divisions under the same head. So they wanted to form a new company with this. So this division Y was sold to another company by name B Limited. Now after the demerger, what happens? A Limited will be left with X Limited and B Limited will acquire Y Limited. Now understand, A Limited should get purchase consideration from B Limited because B Limited is taking over a part of the net assets because the net assets belong to both X as well as Y. So whenever we have such a transaction, the first thing that you need to do is when I give you an A Limited balance sheet, we have to try to split the balance sheet between the division X and division Y. All assets and liabilities can be split to division X and division Y? Not possible. Let's say equity share capital. Let's talk about reserves and surplus. There are very few assets and liabilities which can be split between divisions. Let's say I'm talking about plant and machinery specifically, and I have a particular factory which is only dealing with division X and one more particular factory only dealing with division Y. So all those machinery in division X will be allocated to division X and others will be allocated to division Y. That becomes very simple. But let's talk about corporate assets. They have an administrative office and within that administrative office, let's say they have some furniture. How will you split? That can't be split. So not every asset and liability can be split between the divisions, but there are few assets which can be specifically allocated to each of such divisions. So the first thing that we need to do is we have to look at how to split the given balance sheet between X division and Y division. Now, Y division's net assets will be transferred to B Limited. It is a transaction of sale for A Limited. So whatever net assets calculated book value, compare it with the purchase consideration, the balance should be A Limited's profit. Got it? Now, B Limited is acquiring from A Limited. His acquisition, he'll look at net assets acquired compared with the purchase consideration. He will identify either goodwill or capital reserve. So, whenever we have such a type of transaction, first thing, allocate assets and liabilities to each division to the extent possible. If it is not possible, don't take it then. Subsequently, identify profit or loss on sale to the selling company, then identify goodwill or capital reserve on acquisition for the purchasing company. Now, after this, you can happily start drafting your individual balance sheets of both the companies. One is the selling company A Limited and the demerged company B Limited. So, these are my simple steps when we solve demerger. Demerger problems are very simple. All that you have to do is a little bit of logic application is required in splitting the balance sheet. Once you split the balance sheet, half your effort is already over. Now, every balance sheet should I split? Not necessary. Sometimes, normally the questions are drafted in such a way that they themselves split in the question and give it to you. Now when such a question appears, the question becomes very simple because one particular working note itself is not required now. Got it? Just take down the steps. There's a simple demerger. One second, guys. Let me give you the other type of demerger as well. Let's say, for example, I have again this similar thing, A Limited has two divisions, X and Y. Again, I have B Limited as well. Controlling divisions P and Q. Normally what happens is, let's say A is making losses with Y and profits with X. Similarly, B is making profits with P and losses with Q. Now, where A Limited and B Limited have decided that they cannot make any further efforts to bring these divisions into profits, what they'll try to do is do a simple arrangement. You take my loss making division, you can try to get it into profits. I will take your loss making division and I'll try to bring it into profits. So basically they're trying to shift the management between two loss making companies. Both are loss making companies. All they're trying to do here is trying to rearrange themselves in such a way that they get to manage the other loss making company or other loss making division so that they may make efforts or successful efforts to bring them into profits. Got it? So this is a kind of demerger that you may see. Whenever you are solving this kind of demerger, I have two demergers actually. One, this Y division which is splitting and going into B Limited. This is the purchasing company, this is the selling company. And now, in this case, Q Limited is demerging and merging itself with A Limited. So, B Limited will become the selling company and A Limited will become the purchasing company in such cases. So, basically it's a double demerger transaction and nothing else. Got it? So instead of calculating once, I'll start calculating twice. Yes guys, so let's read through the questions of demerger. 32nd one. Enterprise Limited has two divisions, A and B. Division A making constant profits while Division B invariably suffering losses. On 31st March, division wise balance sheet is given to you. That means he only split the net assets into the divisions. So first type, the first working note is not necessary here when he has given it separately. Division B, along with its assets and liabilities, was sold for 25 crores to Turnaround Limited. a new company who allotted 1 crore equity shares of 10 rupees each at a premium of 15 rupees per share to members of Enterprise Limited. Underline that sentence. The purchase consideration was not paid to the company, but it was directly paid to the shareholders. The purchase consideration should have been paid to Enterprise Limited, but instead directly going to the members. Let's see how to treat such a transaction in full settlement of the consideration and in proportion to their shareholding in the company. Assume there is no other transaction. Pass the journal entries in Enterprise Limited and prepare the balance sheet of Enterprise Limited after the entries in point number 1, and prepare balance sheet of Turnaround Limited as well. So I'm asked two balance sheets. One is of the selling company, other one is a demerged company now. So let's check. So this is a kind of demerger that we are looking at, where division wise balance sheets are already given to me. Let's see first purchase consideration. What method? Observe carefully, he already gave you the value of PC. Division B, along with its assets and liabilities, was sold for 25 crores. They'll allot 1 crore shares at a premium of 15 rupees per share. So we already have the value of the PC straightforward. So this is net payments method. Number of equity shares to be allotted. All rupees in crores, even the balance sheet as well. Issue price per share, 10 rupees share at a premium of 15 is 25. Finally, PC is also 25. Now, the division B is being sold now. Now, for the division B being sold, he is also asking you to pass the journal entries. Let's see how the journal entries are passed. Journal entries in the books of Enterprise Limited, that is a selling company. Only the transaction of sale should be recorded. First thing, Enterprise Limited is selling their net assets to another company called as Turnaround Limited. That Turnaround Limited is receiving the net assets of this division B in Enterprise Limited. Debit the receiver first, simple thing which I understand here. Turnaround Limited debit is a receiving company. Debit the receiver, he is receiving the net assets. 25, that is what they have to pay. Now, what are we doing in Enterprise Limited? The division B is being transferred. So that means the division B's net assets should not be appearing anymore. So that means I have to cancel division B's net assets. How do we cancel division B's net assets? Net assets include both assets as well as liabilities. Liabilities having credit balance, assets having debit balance. If I have to cancel them, debit the liabilities, credit the assets. Come on. Check only B's column and do that. Surplus is just P&L, guys. I can't take that. Loan funds is there. I have to debit this. Loan funds account debit. 300. Anything else? Current liabilities. Yes. Credit balance again. Debit it and close it. Current liabilities, account debit. How much is this? 400. And that's it. Go for the assets. To fix the assets. Net of depreciation, value of fixed assets is 100. Current assets 500. That's it. We have cancelled every figure from the division B's balance sheet. Yes, guys. Now there's one more critical point that we have to see here. I can't leave the entry like this. Because the first thing, the entire transaction, if you observe, is clearly saying the purchase consideration is being allotted directly to the shareholders of the Enterprise Limited. If it was supposed to be received by Enterprise Limited, I can leave it like this. But what am I saying? The Turnaround Limited, whatever 25 he is paying, such payment should be made to the members. So, get the members balance. Member is the balancing figure from the account. $125. Now guys, whatever this Turnaround Limited pays should be received by the members, will not be received by Enterprise Limited at all. So directly paid to the members. How do you pay? Debit the receiver. Members. To Turnaround Limited. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Who gave the PC? Turnaround Limited. Debit the receiver. Who received the PC? The members of Enterprise Limited. Now if you observe, the members are being taken over, their liability to be discharged is 125. For sale of division B, the liability to members is 125. But I settled it with by paying only 25. That means the balance, whatever is there, think from the enterprise perspective, it's a gain for me. Member is having a credit balance in the account. Debit the member for the balancing figure. Members account debit 100. To capital reserve, it's a gain 100. 125 rupees net assets acquired only by paying 25. So 100 rupees is the capital reserve. Yes guys, so he's asking you the balance sheet of both Enterprise Limited as well as Turnaround Limited. Now think from Turnaround's perspective, what do we have to calculate? For the purchasing company, we have to calculate goodwill or capital reserve. So let's try to get done. Goodwill or capital reserve of Turnaround Limited. How do we get, compare your net assets taken over with the PC? Guys, normally there will be some revaluation to the assets when they are taking over. Well, in this question, since it is the first question, there is nothing as such, plain question. Fixed assets 100, current assets 500, total assets is 600 less outside liabilities . Current liabilities are 400 . Loan funds are 300 . Net assets taken over negative 100 guys, negative 100. Assets are only 600, liabilities are 700, negative 100. Purchase consideration, how much did he pay for acquiring these net assets? 25. Goodwill or capital reserve? We get a goodwill or capital reserve? Negative net assets acquired by paying 25. You get a goodwill. I am paying more than the value of the net assets. How much more than the value of the net assets? 125 more than the value of the net assets. Well, this is negative and this is positive. Sufficient enough information available with you. Continue. Continue with the balance sheet. Guys, remember one simple logic, okay? Whenever we have a situation like this, and let's say, instead of in the question saying that the PC was given to the members, let's say the PC was received by Enterprise Limited themselves. In such a situation, if everything is taken over at book values, this fellow's loss should be this fellow's gain. So if this fellow's capital reserve is 100, this fellow's goodwill also would have been only 100. But logic simple here is, this 25 was directly paid to the members, so I'm getting only a capital reserve of 100. Otherwise, I would have got a capital reserve of 125. Loss of turnaround limited is 125. 25 rupees of the gain enterprise limited, that 25 rupees of a gain was received by the members. 100 rupees of a gain was received by the company. So that is the reason why we split 125 separately. That 25 anyways I'm not showing in the books at all. But here the 125 should appear as a loss. That is transferred to goodwill. Come on guys, let's prepare the balance sheet. April 1, 2012 balance sheet for both the companies. First column for enterprise, then for turnaround. All rupees in crores. Equity and liabilities. Enterprise share capital is 25. Turnaround share capital is only 10 guys. Guys, 1 crore shares of 10 rupees each issued at 15 rupees premium. So only 10. Reserves and surplus. Securities premium. Only for turnaround limited, 15. Each share issued at a premium of 15 rupees. Then I have a capital reserve for enterprise. For sale of division, he made a gain of 100. Other than that, the existing reserve, that is surplus, will appear. Only for enterprise, 75 and nil. non-current liabilities. Loan funds. How much is the loan fund? Entire thing transferred to turnaround already 300. Then comes the current liabilities 25 and 400. Non-current assets, another tangible fixed assets. Tangible fixed assets left out in A is 25, transferred to B is, transferred to turnaround limited is 100. Intangible assets, only for turnaround limited, goodwill is 125. Current assets, 200 and 500. As you can generalize saying that after paying 25 to the members, if the selling company has a profit of 100, then the loss or the goodwill to the purchasing company is 125, provided there is no revaluation to your net assets. If there is a revaluation to your net assets, then again this 125 will go for the toss. Got it? So this fellow's 125 loss to the enterprise limited, 25 rupees of a gain went to shareholders, 100 rupees gain was parked into capital reserve in the books of company. Now it's a balance sheet. Simple tiny balance sheet, guys. Demergers, they will not ask you big questions. Go for the 33rd. Summarized balance sheet of Z Limited as on 31st March 2012 is given below. In its respective shares of the companies, two divisions, S and W divisions, are various assets and liabilities as shown below. Guys, don't get confused when you come down to loan funds and say that the total is not tallying. No, how can it be 15 and total being 417? No problem. That means specific to the division W is only 15. The total loan funds of the company are 417. So you don't apply the logic saying that A plus B is equal to C. No. Okay, here you can't have it in all the situations at all. Now, come down below. Loan funds included Interlia bank loans of 15 crores specifically taken for W division and debentures of paid up value 125 crores redeemable at any time between 1st October to 30th September. So those debentures are also included in the loan funds, it seems, which are supposed to be redeemed in the next 6 months. Next. On 1st April 2012, the company sold all the investments for 102 crores and redeemed all the debentures at par, cash being recorded through the bank account pertaining to S division. Very clearly he said such bank account pertains to S division. So there is an increase or decrease in the bank should be given only in division S. Then a new company Y Limited was incorporated with an authorized capital of 900 crores divided into shares of 10 rupees each. All the assets and liabilities pertaining to W division are being transferred to the newly formed company Y Limited, allotting to XZ Limited shareholders, underline that word again, allotting to Z Limited shareholders its two fully paid equity shares at 10 rupees each at par for every fully paid share of 10 rupees in Z Limited in discharge of consideration for the division being taken over. Again, the PC is being payable only to the shareholders of the selling company, not to the selling company at all. Continue. Y Limited recorded its fixed assets at 218 crores and all other assets and liabilities at the same value as it appeared in the books of Z Limited. So don't apply that logic again. Okay, this fellow's loss should be that fellow's gain. No, because whenever there's a revaluation, here there's a revaluation, I can't apply the same logic. Show the journal entries in the books of Z. Prepare Z Limited balance sheet immediately after the demerger and the initial balance sheet of Y. Calculate intrinsic value of one share in Z immediately before and after the demerger. Calculate the gain, if any, per share to the shareholders of Z arising from the demerger. Continue. Let's start with the journal entries in the books of Z. Oh guys, first of all, get the PC. First get the PC. Identify PC guys, PC by payments method or net assets. Yes guys, the PC is by payments method because Y Limited allotted to Z Limited shareholders two fully paid shares at par for each share in Z Limited. That means exchange ratio is 2:1. When exchange ratio is given, purchase consideration is always by net assets method when exchange ratio is available. All rupees in crores again. Number of shares in Z. How many shares are there in Z? Z Limited share capital is 345. Each share is 10 rupees. So my number of shares are 34.5. Exchange ratio. 2 shares for every 1 share held. Number of shares to be allotted by this new company Y Limited is 69. Issue price per share, each share of 10 rupees issued at par. Then my total purchase consideration $690. Record the journal entries in the books of Z. First, come on, PC due. First debit Y Limited because he is receiving the net assets. Debit the receiver Y Limited for the PC 690. Now what do we have to do? Cancel all the liabilities and assets. So debit the liabilities, the first liability which I see there. What division did he take over? Division W. So the second column, come on. Loan funds account debit 15. current liabilities account debit. 93. Cancel the assets to current assets. 585 to fixed assets. 168. Transfer the balance to the members. This is 45. Members' balance is 45. Now, a PC discharge, while limited, is paying to the members, debit the receiver members. How much is the PC? 690. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Giver is Y Limited. 690. PC is discharged. First I cancel the divisional net assets. Then I settle the PC. Now finally check your member's account. Member's account had a credit balance of 45. You debited him with 690. That means ultimately you are incurring a loss. Members account shows what balance? Debit balance, right? So, it should be goodwill account debit. To members. If there was a profit, we would have transferred it to capital reserve. But this is a loss. Put it to goodwill account. Yes guys, go on. Now he's asking me the balance sheet of Z as well as initial balance sheet of Y. So what we'll try to do to prepare initial balance sheet of Y, we need goodwill or capital reserve for Y as well. So identify goodwill or capital reserve for Y. Compare your net assets taken over at the PC. Assets, there's a change to one asset. Fixed assets will be recorded at 218, last para. Current asset, book values, W division current assets are 585. That's it for the total assets. 803. Deduct outside liabilities. How many outside liabilities? 2. Loan funds and current liabilities. How much loan funds? 15. Current liabilities 93. Net assets taken over. 695. What is the PCU paid for this? 90. I land up with a capital reserve of 5. I land up with a capital reserve of 5. And this is your simple demerger. Come on guys, you can pass. Balance sheet, go on for the balance sheet. Maintain two columns, Z Limited after merger and Y Limited balance sheet. That is the initial balance sheet of Y. Balance sheet as on 1/4/2012. I'll maintain two columns. First one is Z Limited. Second one is Y. All rupees are given in crores. Push up guys. First one, start with the equity and liabilities. Shareholder funds, share capital. Z share capital already existing with them is 345. Y share capital just now issued, all shares are issued at par, 690. Yes guys, next one, reserves. Someone has a capital reserve, pick up that. Capital reserve is 5. Next. Reserves and surplus, other reserves, Z Limited accumulated reserve is 685. Oh, one second guys, this capital reserve is for Y. Yeah. Non-current liabilities. Loan funds, just one second guys, just one second, read the first, no second para. On 1st April, the company sold its investments for 102. What was the book value of investments existing? 97, if it is sold for 102, that means I am earning a profit of 5 there. And they redeemed debentures at par, cash transactions being recorded there, no problem. But this one, your reserve, will not be 685, should be 690. Because of that 5 extra profit on sale of investments. Now come to the loan funds. Z loan funds. Total given there in the balance sheet for you in the question is 417. Out of which 15 belong to W division, which is transferred anyways. Balance loan funds are 402. But out of the loan funds, read down below. He's saying that the debentures had a paid up value of 125 crores, redeemable now in the next 6 months. And he clearly said that 102 crores were investments were sold off and redeemed all the debentures at par. That means even that 125 should be reduced from the value of your loan funds. So your loan funds were 417. Minus 15. 15 belonging to W division will become Y Limited's loan funds now. Balance is 402. out of that 402, 125 is already paid off. 277 is the loan funds. 125 debentures are already settled. 125 figure is there in the second line after the balance sheet, and they are being settled in the second para, and they redeemed all the debentures at par. So 277 and 15. Current liabilities, there is no change. 93 and 270. 270 and 93. Non-current assets, tangible fixed assets. S Limited division will be left out with Z Limited, so their tangible fixed assets are 515. But W division acquired by Y Limited, their net assets, their fixed assets are revalued and recorded at 218. Intangible asset, goodwill for Z, 645. Come to the current assets now. Y Limited current assets is directly W Limited column, 585. But this will change. Already existing 445 plus 102 received from sale of investments minus 125 paid to loan funds. So already existing 445 plus 102. Plus 102 will become The question doesn't end there, guys. Read through. Calculate the intrinsic value of one share of Z immediately before and immediately after demerger. Calculate the gain, if any, per share to the shareholder of Z arising from the demerger. So let's see. Intrinsic value per share. Z Limited pre-demerger post demerger. Also for another company, Y Limited. So maintain three columns. Intrinsic value means assets minus outside liabilities. Correct? So start doing that. Fixed assets pre-demerger, before demerger is 683, after demerger is 515, Y Limited demerger is 218. Guys, this goodwill will not have a value. This was basically loss. It was not acquired goodwill. You can't take any value for this. Directly take current assets. Pre-demerger, before the demerger even happened, what is given in the balance sheet total? 1030. Post-demerger, 422. Y Limited, 585. Asset total. Reduce your liabilities, loan funds and current liabilities. Loan funds pre-demerger, 417. Post-demerger, 277. Y Limited, 15. Current liabilities pre-demerger, 363, 270 and 93. Total is 363. Post demerger 270 and 93. 1713. This is 780. My net assets will be 733 actually. Next one, post demerger is 937, this one is 547, and this is 390. This total is 803, this total is 108, and this total will be 695. First one is 933 divided by number of equity shares. There is no preference shares, so this only will be net assets available to equity shareholders. Z Limited, be it pre or post, it was always 34.5. Y Limited, it was 69. Calculate intrinsic value per share. Is 10 point change. These are the intrinsic value per share. It's trying to ask you in the last question, what is the gain to each shareholder of Z arising from demerger? Gain from demerger. Two shareholders. Yes, guys, gain from demerger to the shareholder. You need to calculate. Pre-demerger, he had one share in Z, correct? So Z Limited is 27.04. But post-demerger, each shareholder has now two shares. One share in Z, 11.3, plus two shares in Y, because the exchange ratio was 2:1. So for every one share in Z, I was receiving two shares. So I'll receive two shares in Y. There is a gain. Gain per share is 4.4. Yes, guys, read question number 34. Following is a draft balance sheet of Divers Limited having an authorized capital of 1000 crores as on 31st March 2012. Some balance sheet that has been given to us. Capital commitments are 700 crores and the company consists of two divisions. Established division whose gross block is Y. Established division whose gross block is 200 and net block is 30. That means the accumulated depreciation is 170 on the fixed assets. Current assets were 1500 and working capital is 1200. Working capital is current assets minus current liabilities. Current asset is 1500. Working capital is 1200 means current liability is 300. The entirely financed out of shareholder funds. That means there is no loan funds which are included in established division. New Project Limited, to which the remaining fixed assets, and current liabilities are related. The following scheme of reconstruction has been agreed upon. Two new companies, Sunrise and Khazana, are formed and the authorized capital of Sunrise is 1000 crores. Authorized capital of Khazana is 500 crores. Khazana Limited will take over the investments at 800 crores and unsecured loan at the balance sheet value. It is to allot 10 rupee equity share at par to the members of Divers Limited in satisfaction of their amount due under the arrangement. Again, be specific, this consideration was paid to the members of Divers Limited. So, not the Divers Limited, but their members directly. Sunrise will take over fixed assets and the net working capital of the new projects division along with secured loans and obligation for capital commitment, for which Divers will continue to stand as a guarantee for the book commitments, to which Divers Limited will continue to stand as a guarantee for the book value. It is to allot 1 crore equity shares of 10 rupees each as a consideration to Divers Limited. So 10 rupees equity share, 1 crore, the purchase consideration is 10 crores. Sunrise made an issue of unsecured convertible debentures of 500 crores carrying an interest of 15%, having a right to be converted into equity shares at par on 31st March 2017. The issue was made to the members of Sunrise Limited as a right, and the right was grabbed by the as an opportunity and subscribed in full. Diverse to guarantee all the liabilities transferred to the two companies, and diverse is to make a bonus issue of equity shares in the ratio of one equity share for every equity share out of revenue reserves. There are some revenue reserves which are given in the question. Use those revenue reserves and issue a bonus of 1:1. Assume that the above scheme is duly approved by the Honorable High Court. No other transaction. Pass the journal entries in the books of divers and the balance sheet of all the three companies. Yes guys, the first thing that we have to do now is first split the balance sheet. Because the divers limited balance sheet that he has given to you is a combined balance sheet. But it includes two divisions, established division and new projects division. So let's try to split the balance sheet first, then we'll go for computation of purchase consideration. Divisional wise balance sheet. Or division wise net assets, right? Done. That would sound better. Of Divers Limited. Two divisions, one is established division and the one is new projects division. Only check your assets and liabilities which can be split. I'll write even the total column as well. What cannot be split, I'll directly put it into the total column. Go on. First one, fixed assets. Fixed assets is writing it as gross block and net block. Gross block minus depreciation will give me net block. What is the gross block? Established division gross block is 200. Net block is 30. That means depreciation is 170. New projects is not given, but is saying that the remaining fixed assets are for new projects. Fill up the total column first. 800 200 600. Now I can fill up the balance. New projects fixed gross block is 600, depreciation is 30, net block is 570. Next one is investments. You cannot allocate it to any particular division. 400. Current assets. Current assets of established division is 1500. Total is 3000. So new project should also be 1500. Total net assets are 1530 2070 4000. Total assets. Outside liabilities. Go in the reverse order. First one we see is current liability. The total is 2000. Division wise. For established division, current assets are 1500 and working capital is 1200. Current liability is 300. So the current liability for new projects division should be 1700. Unsecured and secured loans. Unsecured loans, total column 600. Secured loans. Secured loans has two parts. Secured against fixed assets 300. Secured against working capital 100. Total 400. Net assets are 1230 370 and 1000. They can't total to the same figure because investments was never allocated, your loans were never allocated, you won't get the same figures in total. Now this is my first task to be done, where we split the balance sheet between both the divisions. Now this should be the starting point. Now check the following scheme of reconstruction. Two new companies, Sunrise and Khazana, will be formed and the authorized capital are 1500 crores. Khazana is to take over investments at 800 crores, unsecured loans at balance sheet value, and it will allot equity shares of 10 rupees each at par to the members of divers in satisfaction of the amount due under the arrangement. Now, he never said this much is the amount of purchase consideration, this many number of shares, nothing. So, whenever there is nothing given, we have to follow purchase consideration by net assets method. Purchase consideration, the first company that we are talking about, for Khazana Limited. Net assets method. Come on. Khazana Limited is to take over the investments taken over at 800, unsecured loans at balance sheet value, so less, there is a liability, unsecured loan is 600, purchase consideration is 200, issue price per share is 10. Number of shares. To be allotted as 20. This PC of the first company, Khazana. There is one more demerger which happened. Read through point number C. Sunrise took over the fixed assets and the networking capital of new projects. This is what I am talking about. And then along with the secured loan obligation, okay, there's an additional asset he's taking over, additional liability, and also he's taking over an obligation for capital commitments, which was given as a contingent liability in the Divers Limited balance sheet. Contingent liability, capital commitments are 700, to which Divers Limited will continue to stand as a guarantee for the book values. They will allot 1 crore equity share of 10 rupees each to Divers Limited to the as a consideration to Divers Limited. Guys, this is not a consideration paid to members of Divers, guys. If you read very carefully, it is to allot 1 crore equity shares of 10 rupees each as consideration to Divers Limited. That's it. So calculate the PC, 1 crore shares of 10 rupees each, obviously your PC is 10 crores. Sunrise Limited. Payments method. Number of equity shares to be allotted, 1, issue price per share is 10, PC is 10 crores. Pass the journal entries in the books of Divers Limited is the first question. Journal entries in Divers. Limited. What is the first thing that happened? First is sale to Khajana. Khajana Limited will take over the investments of 800 crores and unsecured loans at the balance sheet value, and it is to allot rupee 10 share at par to the members of Divers Limited. So debit the receiver, Khajana Limited. PC for Khajana Limited is 200. He is taking over investments and unsecured loans. Unsecured loans liability, let me cancel that first. Unsecured loans account debit 600. Is also taking over investments, so credit the investments. It has a debit balance in the books at 400. Balance PC should be received by members, so credit the members. So the balance 400. The members should be paid the PC. Debit the receiver, members. Debit the receiver, credit the giver. Who will give? PC will be paid by Khajana Limited. 200. Remaining balance of members balance, credit balance of 200 will be transferred to capital reserve. With that, we come to the end of first takeover. The first takeover, that is Khajana Limited entry. There is one more company which has come into picture, that is Sunrise Limited, which is taking over the New Projects Limited along with secured loans as well as capital commitments. So let's get to that. But guys, he never said that the PC is paid to the shareholders. He clearly said it is to allot 1 crore shares of 10 rupees each as a consideration to Diverse Limited, not to shareholders of Diverse. So as if the shares are received by this company itself. Come on. Sunrise Limited account debit. What is the PC? Sunrise 10. What are they taking over? They are taking over the entire new projects. So cancel all liabilities along with secured loans. So first of all, let me cancel the secured loan. Credit balance debited, it will get cancelled. Secured loans account debit 400. What else liability is there? Current liability is there for new projects. Also gets cancelled. Current liability account debit 1700. That's it. Come on. Come to your credits. Keep cancelling your each asset. To fixed assets. Net block value is 570. To current assets, 1500. Directly you will get goodwill or capital reserve, guys. Don't transfer it to members. Member has nothing to do with this takeover at all. Looks to be a capital reserve of 40. PC should be settled. The shares will be received by Diverse Limited. So debit what comes in? Equity shares in Sunrise Limited account debit. To Sunrise Limited. The Sunrise Limited gets cancelled. Additional investments I get. Equity shares in Sunrise Limited. Yes, guys. No recording contingent liabilities, guys. They are not debits, no credits. You don't pass an accounting entry for the contingent liabilities at all. So, what else? Journal entries are done as far as Diverse? No. Because Diverse Limited, there's one more transaction that should be considered. That is point number E. Diverse Limited will make a bonus issue to the equity shareholders in the ratio of 1 share for every share held. Check. What are the reserves existing? 750. Equity shares are only 250. Happily make bonus. Entry should be use the reserve. Revenue reserve to bonus payable. One is to one bonus. So 250 rupees again. Bonus payable to equity share capital. That is it, that we come to the end of the entries in the books of Diverse. Subsequently, he is asking me to prepare the balance sheet of all the three companies, which will require a little bit of effort because we need to calculate goodwill or capital reserve. We need to calculate goodwill or capital reserve on acquisition, guys. Before the balance sheet, yes, calculate goodwill or capital reserve. Two companies, two columns. The first company is Khajana. Second one is Sunrise. Khajana's net assets taken over are 200. Because directly we calculated the PC by net assets method. What is the Sunrise Limited net asset? Sunrise is taking on new projects, 370. Along with that, he is also taking over secured loans. So he is also taking over secured loans, which is an additional liability of 400 being taken over. So 370 already existing net asset. So one more additional liability of 400 if you take over, that will start showing a negative 30. Guys, capital commitments are also taken over, but it is a contingent liability. I don't have to bother about that. Net assets taken over should be compared with PC. PC, this is 2. This is 10. Goodwill is nil and 40. How come this is 40? This capital reserve will be exactly equal to the goodwill. How come here it is same? In the previous cases, we were saying that a portion of the gain was going to the member. That is the reason why I was saying this two cannot tally. But now, one fellow's loss is other fellow's gain unless and until there is a revaluation to the asset. There is no revaluation to the asset, so both tallied. Here it will be zero because you calculated as per net asset method. When you calculate as per net assets method, you won't get any gain or loss. So, balance sheet. Maintain three columns in the balance sheet, guys. Maintain three columns. Divers Limited, Khajana, Sunrise. Divers, Khajana, Sunrise. Equity and liabilities. Shareholder funds, share capital. Divers Limited share capital already existing was 250. Bonus they got, so this will become 500. What did Khazana give? Khazana gave 200 worth shares. What about Sunrise? Only 10. Reserves and surplus. Come on. I have a capital reserve. There is no securities premium. Everyone's shares are issued at par. Capital reserve. For Khazana being taken over, capital reserve is 200. For Sunrise being taken over, capital reserve is 40. Divers Limited has a capital reserve of 240. Sunrise has a goodwill, guys. Other than this, there is a revenue reserve as well. Out of this 750, I already used 250 for bonus. So balance I'll get only 500. Continue. What else? Non-current liabilities. Under non-current liabilities, I have secured borrowings and unsecured borrowings. Secured borrowings. Someone took over secured borrowings. Who was he? Secured loans were gone. Secured loans are taken over by Sunrise Limited. So secured loans in the books of Sunrise. 400. Unsecured borrowing. Unsecured borrowing was taken over by Khazana at balance sheet value. Unsecured borrowing balance sheet value is 600. Next. Read Sunrise Limited carefully. Come down. Sunrise Limited made an issue of unsecured convertible debentures of 500 rupees carrying an interest of 15% per annum. So 15% debentures only for Sunrise, 500. With that, we come to the end of non-current liabilities. Strike the current liabilities now. Current liabilities established division is still with divers. So established division current liability as 300. New projects division transferred to Sunrise. New project division current liabilities are 1700. That is it. Assets. Non-current assets. Tangible fixed assets. Divers Limited still has established division which has a net block of 30. New projects division which has a net block of 570 transferred to Sunrise. Next. Investments. What happened to the investments? Investment got transferred. Someone took over the investments check. He took over investments for 800. Goodwill. Only for Sunrise. Intangible asset 40. Write intangible and then write goodwill below that. That's it. Get your current assets. Established division current assets still with divers 1500. Sunrise, it should be 1500 with new projects, but in addition, since he issued 500 crores of debentures, that also gets added because it is also for cash. Normally it should be only 1500, but since you have written this 15% debentures here, this 1500 should be now written as 2000. Because that 500 rupee debentures are issued, so they have been taken up, cash should be received for that. That's it, check your balance sheet totals. Guys, we forgot one figure, guys. Equity shares in Sunrise Limited which were received by divers will become an investment. Under investments, equity shares in Sunrise. They have acquired this investments in Sunrise that is not paid to members. If it was paid to members, then it will not appear in the balance sheet of divers. It was paid to Sunrise Limited. Sorry, Divers Limited. So, take the 10 rupees as well. Balance sheet totals are 1540, 800, 2610.